what's up? This is your girl, Dirty Ikwere Girl Achiru, coming to you all the way from London, UK. And I am the only Ikwere girl, the one and only Ikwere girl living in London. Argue with yourself. Anyway, why am I here today? Very quickly, because it's like -3 degrees and I still have to shoot my video in the bush. What is wrong with me? Anyways, why are we here today? Very quickly, my guy, President Muhammadu Buhari. You see, last week we were talking about how the scary sleepless nights over people in Libya. My people, you guys need to smart up. Why is he using sleep over people in Libya? You need to understand now, Libya. What's the common denominator? Buhari Muslim, Libya, populated by Islamist people. Now, without, no pun intended, but this is how it works. Now, the only reason why he wants to go and solve the problem there, because he's creating allies. Remember when I said, yes, I said it, allies. He's trying to create allies, and that's what he's doing. It's as simple as that. Now, in Nigeria, the situation is that they've solved insurgency, but they're still struggling with terrorism. Oh boy, yeah. Another thing that Nigerians are worried about is that President Trump, I'm not a fan of Mr. President Trump, by the way, but President Trump has put that Nigeria, amongst other countries, on the travel ban. You guys are crying out loud, and there's a stat that shows that Nigerians are supporting them. Now, when you look at the stats and say Nigerians are hailing him, the first thing you need to understand is CNN and the rest of them, don't take this just seriously. Nigerians are the most unserious people ever. We just play. We play too much. In fact, that's our slogan. We play too much. Have you seen the messages we sent to President Trump? All kinds of things. So please, don't take it seriously. Whether we support or not, you can't determine it by the graph. He put the survey out there. We'll all say yes, we support him. Because we don't win it. We just say whatever we want to say. So Nigeria on the travel ban. The two times in the history of mankind that Nigeria has been put on the travel ban, who was the president? Muhammadu Buhari. Common denominator, Buhari, travel ban, America. What is the problem? Now, back it up before you start getting angry with Mr. Trump. Guy, what are you planning? Twice you've been president, Nigeria has security issues. Sorry, I keep saying Mr. Trump, no disrespect, but it's just that we called him Mr. Trump for so long that adding president to it, especially for so many reasons, it's quite difficult to remember he's the president. But anyway, Nigeria travel ban twice. Who was the president when Nigeria was placed on travel ban? In the history of humanity, Buhari was the president. Now, why did America, forget Trump, why did America put Nigeria on the travel ban list? Not only Nigeria, other countries, all of these countries have failed to pass the security test. They failed to release security information. Does that surprise you? Now, when you're not able to release security information, you are the best person that was president the last time. This same thing happened. Now it's happened again. What's this guy up to? Seriously, guy, wait till you plan. Our soldiers are dying out there. They catch Boko Haram. You put them in rehabilitation. They repent and you put them out there and then they become terrorists again. That doesn't sound right. Boko Haram takes no prisoners. Except women anyway. Young virgins. But they take no prisoners. They just kill, maim, destroy, behead, all those things. So now our soldiers, our boys, are going out there trying to defend the security and defend the oaths, the vows they made to the country. They catch these terrorists. You put them in rehabilitation and you send them back out there to fight us. Come on now, this is just a joke now. A couple of years ago, Boko Haram nominated Buhari as the person, their spokesman, to negotiate with the government of Nigeria. The same guy, but he's our president. Then you wonder why America banned Nigeria, travel ban. In fact, they should all cut you guys out of the world. Yes, I said it. Come and beat me now. You all understand, don't stay in your cubicle and say you're fine. Headsman or whatever it's called, they called, they have spread all over. Yeah, this is the situation. This is the real gist. Now, there's this other guy, Mr. Mugu. Oh, sorry, Mr. Mag. I can't even give a straight face. Mr. Maga. Sorry, I don't know. Mr. Magu. No, Maju. Something like that. Anyway, you know, this guy is the boss of EFCC. And he says that he believes strongly that the cause of coronavirus is corruption. Jesus is Lord. Now, with the corruption going up in Africa, right, we are supposed to have been extinct a long time ago if it's down to corruption. Because the people that are breeding it, their corruption is still the land work. But saying that, maybe the reason we've not been extinct is because the cure of coronavirus is in our blood. Now, so a couple of Chinese doctors kind of had it when they said they got this black guy and the guy was not dying. So there must be something in the African blood or African DNA. Now, let me educate the Chinese doctors. What's happened is that it is chloroquine phosphate. So what's happened is that for years and years and years, our ancestors have been taking chloroquine injection. They shook you in the bum and that's it. We've taken it so much that the thing has become a part of our blood. It's like when you sneeze, is chloroquine. You see, someone like me, right? I've not taken chloroquine in maybe 40 years now or something like that. But I bet you if you take my blood and test it, it's still 95% positive chloroquine. So the truth is, it's not so much of the African DNA, because if you bring an African that has been in Obodo Ibo and you take them to solve corona, they will die. You don't go and try it on black people out there. They will die. You're looking at the pure breeds, the ones DNA which has SARS, the ones that their foot is etched in the soil. You understand what I mean? If you're not one of those that they shook you that thing and your body eat you like they robbed the new yam, then trust me, don't be trying that corona thing. And then, coming back, there's some people in China, our Nigerian brothers in China, they were trying to come back home. They said the whole bring back our Chinese, our brothers in China. People were talking about it on Facebook, and trust me, I just love to read Facebook comments. I'm not so much interested in the post, but the comments. I am the chairperson, Comments Readers Association. The comments here, they're to die for. Seriously, we will not die. So the Chinese guys, the guys in China, they said, we want to come back, help us come back. People on Facebook said, stay there. When you were having your money and making money in China, did you help us? Did you help? So people say, oh, that's a bit insensitive. What do you mean? Someone said, okay, no, fine. Basically, it is more effective or less hazardous for them to stay in China, because in China, they got the facilities to contain this thing. If you send them back to Nigeria, personally, I'm looking at extinction. I don't care about chloroquine or anything. But hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. The answer has come, my brothers out there in China. Tell your family members to send you shiploads of chloroquine. If the one in your blood has drained out due to eating sushi and the rest of them, let them send you chloroquine. That's the answer. Just take it. If I overdose on it, you're fine. Speaking about overdose, you know how people be hustling with Tramadol and the rest of them, they can't afford it, looking for one, sniffing pains here and there, trying to find something like bow that makes you run mad? The answer has come. My northern sisters, Ariwa sisters, Ariwa women, what will I not hear in this world? So Ariwa women have devised a way to get high for $120. So basically, 100 naira Coke, Coca-Cola, and 20 naira Maggi cubes. Maggi cube with a star. Right, so what these women are doing is they mix this, the Maggi. I don't know how they do it anyway, let me not try to. But basically, a combination of Coca-Cola and 20 naira Maggi will just boom, blow your head up. So don't say I didn't do anything for you, eh? Don't spend your money on Tramadol. Go for Maggi and say, shut up your mouth, say no to drugs. See your life. See the kind of gist that people like. But anyway, Ariwa sisters, what's up now? Isn't it easier for you to just go for a wedding, just cook better jollof rice, cook soup, egusi, brokoto, everything, put Maggi inside, buy a big bottle of Coke, chop the brokoto, drink the Coke, and then the feeling is good. You understand? I've always wondered why, when I make better soup, I put Maggi, put salt, smell well. Coke, I always like Coke, I drink Coke. I just noticed that I just feel like, everything I one love, I and I. Thanks and praise to them. I'll just be like glowing. I didn't know that it's the Maggi and in the food and the Coke I was drinking. So, not deviating. Ariwa sisters, and please stop mixing these things. You don't understand what's going on. And people, I'm not trying in any way to enable this gist. Please stay away from Coke and Maggi, except to eat inside food. You understand? Stay away. The other one that is quite interesting, and the gist is kind of dying now, is, whew, this man comes from Canada. He wants to relocate his family back to Obodo Ibo. Canadian embassy's policy says you need to prove paternity. So in order to prove paternity, DNA. We go and do the DNA now. Three children. Bah! No one is his child. Guy gets angry. Poop, 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 poop. Practices his boxing and takes out four of his wife's teeth. Now the gist now. Like I said, the gist died because what's happened is happened. There are those that say, oh yeah, she deserved it. Those that say, oh, no to violence, and those that say this and that. That's not my problem right now. My problem right now is that I'm here to tell you that DNA, my message to the world is say no to violence and don't be quick to react, because you never know. Okay, outside the fact that there's a nurse that confessed to exchanging over 10,000 babies during her career. 10,000 babies. So there's loads of people out there that have children that are not their own and they don't know. Until the day they want to go to Canada or anywhere, they say proof paternity then. So in this case, I'm trying to bring to the public now. You see DNA, right? It is 90 to 99% accurate. And this is if terms and conditions are favorable. If it's in a good lab and in good condition. That's the catch. Coming back. You see condom, right? Durex is 98% accurate. You see how many people come back with stories that touch, say, but I use condom now, boy, and she can't get belly. She got pregnant. That's what I'm trying to say. If condom there is 98%, people still getting pregnant left, right, and center. How about the DNA that is 90 to 99% in a favorable condition? So, we're talking about DNA that was done in Nigeria. I don't know where they did DNA. I don't think the Canadian embassy is doing the DNA for people. I think people just go there, go away, do it, and come back. How accurate is it? Now, I'm not saying that it is wrong, but I'm saying that sometimes, yeah, before you react, take a step back, breathe. You understand? Let's say now, they come back now and say, the result was wrong, and bros, those 4 children are your own. How you want to take back? This is your girl, Dot Ikoregirl Achiru, coming to you all the way from London. My Friday musings in the bush, -3 degrees, and I still came to you. Show love, people, and I'll catch you later. Until next Friday, be blessed.